I think that, and I wrote some of this in the book. One of the stories that I talk about in the book is when I was 4 years old, my dad had forced me to eat carrots at the dinner table. I ended up vomiting, and he got very angry and picked me up and threw me in the garbage. And so, I talk about in the book, fast forward from 4 years old to late 20s, my wife and I are at a wedding, and there's steak and there's potatoes and there's carrots, and I didn't even, Johnny, I didn't even think anything of it. And so I take my fork and I stab it into the carrot and I bring it up and I take a bite, and immediately I start to gag. So it has been things like that that I've noticed triggers things from the past, or not the past, when they come up in the present, unresolved things. Another thing I don't talk about in the book, but I found this really interesting, is that when my dad would come home, I would get very anxious as a child, but I would know that he got home because the garage, or that he was coming home because the garage door was going up. So now you fast forward to being married for quite a few years, and we move into our one house, and it has garage doors, with electric garage doors. And so when my wife comes home from work, from school, where she works, the garage door goes up, and my heart begins to pound, and I feel this sense of dread. So I wanted to write about my process of being able to backtrack in so many areas and pick up on triggers that I found in my body, that I would feel panic in my body and I wouldn't know why. But then as I would backtrack, or I would have a counselor help me, or just reassure me that there's something there going on, I've been able to put quite a few of those together.
It's so interesting. I think, and especially in today's culture, where terms like trigger warning, things like that, they're thrown around so much in popular culture that I think that's one of the problems with that, is it really loses some of its meaning when it's just spread so much. But that is exactly what that is. You weren't it. You're eating that dinner. You're not, oh man, let's think about childhood trauma. Like that was not at the top of your mind at all. But it's immediate. It's just right there. I've had a similar experience. It's not a traumatic one, but just a where did that come from type of moment, where I was in Walmart. This has been several years ago, and my grandma had died at that point, maybe a year or two prior. And it was sad, but I wasn't like still really distraught or anything like that. So it wasn't on the top of my mind. And I'm just walking through Walmart, and this older lady walks by, and bam, she had the same perfume that my grandma had. And there we go. Now I'm thinking about grandma. There's those emotions.
Absolutely.
So it's just that same thing, but when it comes to trauma, it can be that much more intensive.